Hello, fellow bibliophiles, and welcome back to Blatantly Bookish, and welcome to another day of Vlogmas. Today, I would like to talk with you guys about a slightly different subject, and that is tea. I absolutely love, love, love curling up with a cozy book and a nice cup of tea in the dead of winter, and especially around the holiday season. So I've actually accumulated quite a bit of holiday tea, and I thought I would share that with you guys today. I'm actually drinking one of them right now, but I will put it down to discuss the rest of the teas with you guys. So last year for the holidays, my husband got me a tea advent calendar, and it was David's tea, and there were just a whole range of different types of teas, all, well, mostly holiday-themed teas, but I found that I didn't have enough holiday-themed teas, and there were a lot of teas that I just didn't enjoy. There were a lot of herbal teas that I didn't like. My favorite type of tea is strong black tea with a little flavor to it. Flavored black teas are really my favorites, and I like putting a splash of milk in them. So any tea that can't hold milk is not one that I typically enjoy, though there are plenty of exceptions to that rule for me. But this year, I wanted to do something a little different. Instead of having David, whoever that is, pick the teas, I wanted to pick the teas myself. So I found these rather cheap teas online, just 1 ounce samplers, and I got a whole bunch of them, and I put them in these little packets and labeled them, and I had my husband put them in the little advent calendar pouches. It's been going so well, and I absolutely love all the teas. In fact, one of the teas, both me and my husband liked so much that I ordered a bigger sample of it to have for the rest of the holiday season. So some of the teas in those little pouches include Frosty Plum Spice, which actually has a bit of a floral vibe to it, which is exciting. I've got German Gingerbread, which is a black tea that has cloves and anise and I think safflower petals, all these really wonderful things. I think this might be one of my favorites from the tea advent calendar that I created this year. There's also Christmas Blend, which I think is really festive because it has these little candies inside. Flavor-wise, it's okay. It's just, you know, a black tea with some cinnamon and other kinds of flavors. We have Sugar Plum Pudding, which just tastes really sweet. Like, it's a delicious black dessert tea that I absolutely love. And my favorite tea from the advent calendar so far has been Santa's Milk and Cookies. When you smell this tea, it smells just like cookies. It smells like tea and cookies together, and it is just delightful. It's got this like nutty taste to it, and it's amazing. This one is my absolute favorite, so much so that I got a whole lot more of it delivered, and will be enjoying this all winter long, I can tell you right now. Some other teas in that advent calendar that I don't have extras of are Nutcracker Rooibos, which is surprisingly good. That one is nutty, but in a different way. It's more of like an almond amaretto kind of flavor going on. And of course, that one is caffeine free because as much as I love my black tea, I usually get a little jittery afterwards, which it's okay. And the last tea that's in that advent calendar that I don't think I mentioned yet is Holiday Winter Spice. And that one is just a really spiced black tea. So it's got some citrus notes to it, some clove, some cinnamon, and probably some cardamom too. It's an extra spicy blend and it's quite delicious as well. But like I said, the Santa's Milk and Cookies is probably my first favorite, followed by the gingerbread, the German gingerbread, followed by the Nutcracker Rooibos, actually, which isn't even a black tea, but I told you, I'm full of contradictions and surprises. So some of the other teas that are not in the advent calendar that I have Sip and Be Merry, which is premium black tea with caramel, vanilla, and cardamom. And this is by Republic of Tea. This is actually what I was drinking earlier. I thought I did not like this tea, But I put two tea bags in this time, and it turns out that it is amazing. It was just too weak for me to enjoy. So when you make it with one tea bag, I steep it for like 10 minutes and it just tastes bitter. It doesn't hold its milk very well, and it was really a disappointment. But the two tea bags, it's perfect. 5 minutes steep, holds its milk, and now I really want to drink it again. I love tea. It's just like a warm hug. So Republic of Tea actually had this little promotion going, and you can get your own sampler pack. So I also got other holiday teas, most of which I haven't tried yet, so I can't really speak to them. But I'm a little worried about them being weak like the other tea was. So this one, it seems, was a free sample because I definitely did not order this one. This is Red Hot Holiday Tea. It's herbal, it's caffeine free. It's not my usual type of thing that I enjoy, but I'll probably try it at some point anyway. And then we have Comfort and Joy, also by Republic of Tea. This is just a standard holiday blend, a little cinnamon, a little cardamom, I think. I haven't actually tried it, so I don't know if I'll enjoy it. But if it's too weak, there is a second tea bag of this in my little collection, so we're all set. Caramel vanilla sounds great. Pumpkin spice, it's a black tea that is supposed to be extra spicy and pumpkiny, and I'm excited for that. I've got peppermint chocolate, which sounds absolutely amazing, but I'm a little worried about it. It's an herbal tea, so it's a rooibos, and that could really go either way for me. I've got red velvet, which is also a rooibos, red velvet chocolate. It just sounds really appealing, but I'm a little worried if I'm actually gonna like it or not, which is why you get this sampler pack. I also have peppermint bark, which is, again, very similarly a rooibos tea. And then I couldn't resist, I got one of Twinings Christmas teas that they have. It's a black tea, and like many of the other black teas, it claims to have sweet and savory spice flavors of cinnamon and cloves. So all of these teas actually sound really similar, but to me they taste a little different. But their adjectives are the same, so cinnamon, cloves, you'll hear quite a lot of that in this video. So everyone knows that I like tea, and my brother actually got me tea for Hanukkah. So not all of these are holiday themed teas, but I was gifted them for the holidays, so that's why they're in this video. We have these beautiful tins from Harney & Sons, which is one of my favorite tea stores in New York City. I love going there and trying the teas out. I really miss that since the pandemic, so he brought me some teas to try myself without even having to go to the store. The first one is Celebration. It is black tea with fruit and nut flavors. It sounds like something I would really, really enjoy. The next tea is Earl Grey. I actually don't have Earl Grey around right now, so this is perfect. I think these tins are just so beautiful. I'm probably going to save them even after I finish the tea and just put different teas inside of them and use them forever and ever because, yeah, they're gorgeous. We have Victorian London Fog, which sounds wonderful. It is smooth black teas with bright citrus, sweet vanilla, and lavender. So it sounds like a little more of a floral tea, but also really great, and it has that background of black tea to it. I'm sure I'll enjoy it. And last but not least, my brother got me blueberry green tea, which to me does not scream holiday season. However, I think this would be really nice in the summertime. I'm not the biggest fan of green teas, but I do enjoy them from time to time. And I find myself going in and out of different fads of tea. So right now I am very into black teas and do not want to drink anything else. But I've had times where I enjoy green tea. I've had times where there's one specific herbal tea that I'm obsessed with, although herbal is not my thing. The safest tea to get me is always black tea, and I think a lot of people know that about me. So that was my little holiday tea collection. I hope you enjoyed it. This is a completely unsponsored video. This is just the random assortment of teas that I have accumulated for the holiday season. I am curious to hear if you have your own stash of holiday teas, if you even like drinking tea while reading. Is there a particular type of tea that's your favorite while reading? Does what type of tea vary on what you're reading? I personally just like black tea for pretty much all my reading needs. I'd love to talk all about tea and reading in the comments down below. So until next time, I look forward to seeing you in another video soon. Bye.